Hey there everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, I will review some formulas that you can use on your text or string functions in Excel. For example, here is the name Albert Einstein. In this video, I will show you how to find the length of the string, a left half of the string, the right part of a string, and a middle part, how to convert this text into a lower case, into an upper case, into a proper or title case, find the first name, last name, and use a function called concatenate to combine both the first name and last name to form the full name. So let's get started. Here is the string you need to get information of in cell D3. Column B shows the attribute you want to find, and column C will show you the formulas which we will use to find the attribute. To find the length of the string, you need to use the function length. So in cell D5, we will put the formula is equal to len of the text, which out here is cell D3. That will show you that this cell D3 contains 15 characters. To find the left part of a string, let's say of 5 characters, you need to use the formula left, use the function, and the number of characters, we'll choose 5. This will show the first 5 characters of the cell from left side. Similarly, for right, you need to use the formula right of the text, which again is cell D3, and the number of characters. I'm going to stick to 5, and this will show the first 5 characters from the right side, which is STEIN. The mid formula shows the middle part of the string. Let's use the formula MID, the text. Start number shows from where you want to start, so I'm going to choose the position 4. And number of characters, again, let's stick to 5. And this will show the middle part of the string from position 4 of 5 characters. The case of cell D3 is inconsistent. If you want to convert the whole thing to lowercase, you can use the formula lower and the text. Cell D9 shows the whole text in lowercase. Similarly, for uppercase, you can use the formula upper. And again, the cell D3 will convert the whole string to uppercase. If you want to change it to proper or title case, where just the first alphabet of each word is capitalized, you can use the function proper, again with the text, and this will just make the first character of each word as capital. To find the first name, we need to use a couple of formulas, that is left and search. We'll first start by searching for the blank space in the cell D3. So that can be done by using the formula is equal to search of find text. The text we need to find is a blank space, and within text cell D3. This shows that the blank is in the position 7 of cell D3. To find the first name, now we can use the formula left. So let's add to this left of the text, which is a complete cell D3, comma. The number of characters here would be the position of the blank minus 1, so which is search minus 1. There you go. This will give you the first name. To find the last name, you build on the same formula as first name, but add another formula of length. So let's start by first finding out the number of characters you need to take on the right side. So this would be here again equal to search for, again you find the text blank within the cell D3. This would give 7. But the number of characters we need to take on the right side of cell D3 would be the length of the cell minus the position of the blank. So here you would use the formula len of the cell D3 minus search. So these are the number of characters you need to take from the right side to find the last name. So to finish the formula now, you just again add right of the cell D3, comma, the number of characters, which is the length of the string minus the position of the blank. And there you go. Here you'll get the last name. You can also combine two cells in Excel by using the formula concatenate. In this case, let's try to build the full name using the first name and last name information. So in cell D14, you would put the formula equal to concatenate of the text one, which is cell D12, comma, you need to add a blank, comma, and cell D13. So the full information from the cell D3 has now been calculated using formulas. So if you change this cell D3, let's say to Isaac Newton, the information will now be got for the name in cell D3. I hope that this tutorial was of use to you. If you liked it, please subscribe to my channel. Till next time, ciao.